I'm going to start this video off with a question. How many times have you looked at a scene and thought not to take that image because you didn't think there was going to be anything there, or you didn't wait around long enough for the right subject, or better yet, you took the image and thought straight after taking it, that was no good, and deleted it straight away without any thought going into it? I'm a victim of that myself, because I do that an awful lot. Not so much with waiting for the subject in a scene, but more deleting the photos after I've taken them. And that just causes a whole load of issues when you find that, you know, there might be a really good image there, you just need to look at it for a little while longer, let it stir in your mind for a little bit, maybe take it through the editing process, because as I've mentioned in previous videos, the edit can make a picture look completely different and take an image that didn't look very good and make it look really good depending on what effects you put on it and how you want to portray the image. And it's really important to take more photos, and that's what this video topic is going to be all about. Why people don't take more photos. It's the most important thing as a photographer in my eyes. Just shoot, shoot, and shoot some more, because the more you do, the better you're going to become, and the more photos you take, the more likely you're going to actually have better images as an outcome. And sure, you might have more terrible images, but so what? You know, they're only going to take up storage, and if you've got a storage card or an SD card with a decent amount of storage on it, which, let's face it, it's cheap as chips nowadays to get a really good, high-quality SD card with tons of storage on it, you're not going to be running out of space. And batteries for cameras, there's always third-party batteries, so you can get plenty of batteries, and there's no reason your camera wouldn't last a full day of constant shooting, so why are you still not taking the photo? Let's start with the most obvious thing. You just can't be bothered to get your camera out of your bag. And I've been victim of that before, but now I've remedied that by buying a wrist cuff for my camera from Peak Design. Other brands are available. I just thought that, you know, if it's always on my wrist and my camera's always in my hand, sure, it may be an inconvenience at times, but it's always there and ready to go. Now, I was never really one for keeping my camera and pulling it in and out of my bag all day long. I always had it either around my neck or now in my hand. But ever since buying that about a year ago, I found that I'm not only taking more images, but I'm also quick to the draw if something's happening spontaneously right in front of me. And I'm also, you know, it's always there and ready to go. Even sometimes bringing my hand up to my camera that's around my neck was too much effort for me. So having it around your hands constantly and in the hand to be ready to go at an instant just made me take more photos that way, because I wasn't worried about, I've got to go through the effort of bringing it up, I've got to go through the effort of sorting it out of my bag, getting it all together. So what happens now is my camera comes out of my bag at the very start of the day, stays in my hand, or if the conditions aren't great, around my neck, and then it goes away at the end of the day. Nothing else. It's always in my hand or at reach with me at all times. I know plenty of people that will put it away, pull it out of their pocket if it's a pocketable camera, do all this sort of stuff, and it's just a lot of effort for people. And it doesn't seem like a lot of effort in the grand scheme of things, but trust me, and I know from experience, having it always ready and raring to go, you're taking way more photos that way. And as I said earlier, you may be taking more terrible ones as a ratio, but having it ready and at a moment's notice, and there's no effort behind doing it, you're going to be getting better ones as well. And taking more photos just allows you to filter through the bad ones, get rid of the ones that are really terrible, and then you can just stew on the rest of them, maybe run them through the editing process and see how they turn out that way. The only thing with doing this and finding that I'm taking more photos, make sure you've got an SD card with a hell of a lot of storage. I said this before, batteries are cheap as chips, but having a good SD card and a couple of spare batteries for any camera you're using is a lifesaver. The last thing that you want is walking around all day taking mediocre photos, then you find a scene that you know is going to come of something, and then, you know, your battery runs flat and you don't have a spare, or you've got to go through your previous images and mass delete a few just so you've got some storage left on your SD card. There are very cheap options out there if you're on a budget, but make sure that that is a necessity when you're going out shooting. Just have a couple of spare batteries, have a couple of spare SD cards or a very high storage one, or have a backup one anyway just in case that one fails, but you know what I mean. Just make sure you have plenty of storage, plenty of battery options, and you'll be good to go. you're taking a lot of photos, you're going to want to do that to improve, and you're going to want to be able to have the most options available throughout the whole day when you're going out shooting. Speaking of shooting, how often do you go out and shoot yourself? Because I don't go out as often as I should, admittedly. I go out once a week, maybe once every 2 weeks now, and I really want to get out more, and I'm sure as the spring, summer months roll in, I will be. But if you want to shoot more photos and you want to do more things and improve as a photographer, you need to be going out more. And sure, people can't afford to travel cross-country or into the city every day if they live in just a small town, but go anywhere. Take your camera with you to the shops. You know, you're going for a walk, you might have a pet. Walk your dog, take your camera with you. It's, you know, all these mundane things. As a normal person, you might not see these mundane things as anything, but as a street photographer, and when you get the eye in for the photo, the mundane things is what we look for. You can make some amazing things out of the mundane images, and that's what you need to look for. So literally go out anywhere, have your camera with you. And as I've mentioned before, having a small pocketable lens on your camera body, or having just a pocketable camera in general, or even your phone, it really works well just to capture those snapshots of your day-to-day life, because you will find that something comes of it. And now the thing that I'm most prone to doing myself, and that is deleting your images after you've taken them. Now, although you might be taking more, you might be prone to deleting them as well. That's not the right thing to do either. And I am calling myself a hypocrite here, because I do this even to this day. But when it comes to taking images, sometimes you might not find them good images as soon as you've taken them, but you know, it might become more relevant over time. You know, things might change in the world that thing that you captured a year ago might be really relevant now, or you know, trends change and that thing was, you know, a new trend. All these different things, and it's worth just keeping hold of the images that you've taken. Now for me, I tend to keep all my images on my SD card and then upload them to cloud storage when I get home. And that's where I store all the bulk of my images from all my different trips, categorized into folders. But then throughout my day, I look at the images and delete the ones I don't like. Now, I could have 200-300 images on that day and then finish in that folder with 10 of them. And all these images, yeah, sure, they're good and I like them at the time, but there may be more that I deleted that I might like in 2 months' time, for example. And it might be things that I haven't had a chance to edit yet that I'm just deleting because I don't think it's gonna be good, but I didn't give it the chance to be good because it might not look good raw, but chuck a few edits on there, chuck a few of my presets on there, and it might turn into something. And I've been caught out a few times by doing that. I found images that I thought, wasn't very good, and then I edited it and really liked it. So that's just something to keep in mind as well. Don't delete your images. Get some cloud storage, get some bulk storage anywhere, and you can store hundreds and hundreds of images on there, and you can look through them periodically. Just look through your images and see what you've got, and then you might find something that was a hidden gem. You might have took it ages ago, didn't like it then, but really, really like it now, because as you grow as a photographer, your mindset as a photographer also changes. For example, at the start of my photography journey, I was photographing very documentarian style images. I was taking pictures of people quite up close and focusing on the subject, and now I focus on the scene. No doubt, going back, if I didn't delete some images, there would have been some good scenes there that I liked and now can't look at because they're deleted, they're gone. So always have a backup of your images somewhere. Don't just delete them, put them onto a mass storage somewhere and just keep them and save them for a rainy day, because that's what is going to catch you out. As your trends change, you might have photos from back in the day that you really like now that didn't like then. So really keep hold of your pictures, take some more photos, because what's the worst that can happen? You take more bad ones, but you get more of a chance of getting a good one as well. Just a little one really to talk about that topic, because I know so many people, including myself, that don't take enough photos, don't go out enough, don't store enough of their images, delete them all, and they wonder why they haven't got any images to post, or they haven't got a big portfolio or all these sorts of stuff. So keep hold of your images, store them somewhere, take more, and just go out and shoot, because that's how you improve. That's where you find enjoyment. Thank you for watching. If you did enjoy, a like's always appreciated. Take a look at my new website. By the time this video goes up, would have been live a couple of weeks, but I moved over from Wix to Squarespace because that's where all the cool photographers hang out. Hope you enjoy it. Let me know what you think. Give me some feedback down below in the comments as well. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.